In breaking news, all four of the big banks have now passed on the RBA's rate hike in full, the NAB moving in the last half hour. It is just the beginning for mortgage holders, with predictions we'll see another double hike of interest rates next month, leaving some homeowners concerned they will be forced to sell.
Campbelltown, Sydney's ground zero for mortgage stress, and already yesterday's double rate hike is hitting home.
Feeling very bad, because I have a home loan, big. If interest rate up, how can I survive?
My daughter that's just gone in, and I'm just worried that whether she's still going to be able to afford it once these rates go up.
So far, all four big banks, alongside Macquarie Bank, Virgin Money and ME Bank, have confirmed they'll pass on yesterday's rate rise in full. But the hits will keep coming. CommBank and Westpac now predict another 0.5 hike next month. NAB say we will see it in July and August, with three out of the four big banks anticipating the cash rate will be 2% or above by Christmas.
In historical terms, that's certainly a really quite a rapid pace of tightening, not something we've seen in 20 plus years.
At the moment, the banks have anywhere between 30 to 40% of mortgage holders on fixed rates, safe from rate rises for now, but most are set to expire next year.
And when they do, they could be in for an almighty shock, because their rates could potentially double, if not more.
And it's not just homeowners worried.
A lot of small business owners rely on personal capital to be able to invest in their business, and sometimes even just to pay the bills. So any increase in input costs, including an increase in the interest rate, means that they have to re-examine their business.
Sixte St Hilaire has owned his music store for 5 years. He's worried the skyrocketing cost of living will put him out of business.
This is kind of the thing that's not really a... It's not a necessity, it's a nice to have. In an area like this, which is quite a low socioeconomic area, people are going to start cutting things like this pretty well immediately.
Across the country, Australia is now recording the sharpest slowdown in property prices since 1989. But even with the heat coming out of the market, it's still nothing on recent gains, up 35% during the pandemic.
Southwest Sydney and the Blacktown regions have been performing the best over the past year. And it's the inner city areas and places to the east and north of the city that have shown the weakest price growth.
Now it all depends on how much you owe. Ursula Hager for 10 News First.